Something happened to me last night in a lucid dream that's never happened before. There was two things actually that happened. One of them was something that I did, and the other one was a reason that I became lucid. Okay, so a little bit of context to what's going on in this video is definitely necessary. The reason I had this lucid dream is because of an experiment that I'm running at the moment. I'm doing monthly challenge videos in the new year, and I've started filming it a couple weeks ago. And the one that I'm filming at the moment is waking up at 5 a.m. And I won't go into a lot of detail because you'll understand in the video when it comes out, but things didn't happen very well waking up at 5 a.m. So I changed it up a bit. And part of the changing up involved me sleeping for a bout of time, then waking up, getting up, doing whatever, and then having a one sleep cycle nap 2 hours after I've been awake. That's pretty much it. And then after that sleep cycle nap had happened, so 90 minute nap, I would get up and do my day to see how much of an impact that would have compared to waking up at 5 a.m. Again, more detail in the actual video, which will be somewhere in the middle of January where it comes out. So let's talk about this dream. So I'm in this dream and I'm in a zoo, and this zoo is in Cornwall. Even though we've only got one zoo in Cornwall and it's Newquay Zoo, it wasn't Newquay Zoo, it was like a London Zoo. It's a huge zoo. The woman and I were in this zoo looking at the primates, and we were walking past the primate cages, but then we noticed that the primate cages were kind of on one like wall. And as we went across the wall, walking next to it, looking at the primate cages, we noticed that there were more cages on the right-hand side. So it led from like an open area. We followed the cages and it went into kind of like a tunnel of cages. And then as we progressed down the tunnel, it got darker and darker and the walls of the cage went smaller and smaller. And we were walking down and I thought, this is a bit weird. And Alice was like, I don't like this. I don't like this at all. Can we turn back? And I was like, no. We'll see what's at the bottom of this little tunnel. So we kept on going down this tunnel, and then eventually it just stopped going smaller and smaller. It just stayed at like just over shoulder width, maybe double the width of a shoulder, all the way down. And then I realized that at the bottom of this tunnel, there was nothing. Like, there was no cage. It was just, we were in the monkey cage, kind of. So even though these bits that we were walking down were caged, this bit was open, meaning that all of the primates, all the monkeys, all the apes, all the gorillas, they could run out at us at any point. So I said to the woman, I said, right, yeah, that's fine. We'll turn around. We'll walk back now. As long as we don't make eye contact with the monkeys, we'll be fine. So we walked out, not making eye contact with the monkeys. That's fine. Then we went back home, back here. But it wasn't really our home. It looked, we called it our home, but it didn't look anything like what it does in waking life. And I was lying in bed, and somebody was talking to me about YouTube videos that I was making. Somebody was talking to me about lucid dreaming and teaching lucid dreaming and all of these different things. They were like, well, what would you talk about if you had to do a video on lucid dreaming? I said, well, I'll talk about this and I'll talk about that. And he said, but what if you were teaching somebody to lucid dream? And this guy that I was talking to, it didn't look, I don't know who this guy was. He was just a dream character with a wad of paper in his hands, like reading off it and looking at me and then going, well, what if you did this, this, and this? And I was like, well, I'd do this, this, and this to counteract that. And he kept on probing me with these questions. So after a little while had gone on where I was like, what is your point? He was like, but what if you were in a dream? But he didn't really say it like that. He said it like, what would you do if you realized you were dreaming? And it was at that point where I thought, oh my God, I'm dreaming. I was like, I'm dreaming, aren't I? I said it in my head, but the guy who was standing there with the pieces of paper looking all authoritative, and he was like, nah. And then as soon as I thought I'm dreaming, he looked at me and went, and then he just disappeared. So that was the first thing that happened that was weird in this dream, where I became lucid because a dream character was trying to prompt me to become lucid. And it's really weird that this happened when it did, because not only that night, it was the first time I had this nap, this 90 minute nap. Not only was I talking about, or thinking rather, about how the chances of becoming lucid is greater when you have a nap. That's why the whole process of wake back to bed works so well, is because we nap and it breaks up the sleep cycle in such a way that it makes you become lucid. But because I'm awake for 2 hours, it's not like the traditional 20 minute you're awake and then you go back to sleep. This is 2 hours of wakefulness. So not only was I thinking about that all the time when I was doing, when I was figuring out what my sleep pattern should be, but also the other day I was writing about character-assisted lucid dreaming, how dream characters can make you become lucid rather than of your own deliberate attempt to become lucid. So a character could tell you that you're dreaming, or a character could whatever. And I remembered talking about the time in which I tried to summon my dream character to tell me that I was dreaming. I summoned a dream character once and said, "You will inform me." I don't know why I'm Michael Caine. "You will inform me when I am dreaming." "You will inform me when I am dreaming." Side note, me and my friends the other day, we were talking about what would Michael Caine sound like if he came from South Africa. This is the best way we could describe it. "You are only meant to play the bloody Joseph." I think it's quite good. Anyway, so I think it's quite good that I was writing this down in a book. I'm writing a book, have been for ages, just haven't gotten around to actually completing it. So I was writing this book chapter about becoming lucid through character-assisted lucid dreaming, and how it isn't impossible, but it's very improbable. And then a couple days later, I try and nap, and I'm thinking about how amazing a nap is for lucidity. And then, boom, lucid on the first night. I become lucid through character-assisted lucid dreaming, the technique to achieve a dialed. But I just find it very odd that all of those pieces fitting together. Now, you might be wondering, if you are very observant, that is one thing that's happened to me today in which I became lucid because of that, and it's not really happened that way. But I did say there was two things that happened in my dream that never happened before. I couldn't open any doors. I became lucid, couldn't open any doors. All the doors were locked. So I thought, well, there's an obvious and easy solution towards this. I'll just walk through the doors. Because I wasn't particularly lucid, I was fairly lucid. Obviously, I had some control because of what I'm about to tell you, but I just open the door. I just open the door, I'm lucid, you know. If I was very lucid, I wouldn't need a key, I wouldn't need to do this weird technique that I tried. I just open the door. But I couldn't open the door, couldn't find the key, so I just walked through it, and instead of walking through a door and phasing through the door like you would see in like The Flash or some other TV show where they just like a ghost like going through the door, it was kind of like I pushed through the door. What I did was I kind of leant into it. I pushed my shoulder up against the door and kept on applying pressure until the door kind of warped around me. And it was like, the only way I could describe it was, the door was made out of glass, like molten glass, like you'd see a glass blower. And I was the air that was pushing the glass out of the way. And I would kind of get to a point where I think, this is gonna break, the door's gonna break. And it was like bubbling outwards in the shape of gears. And then I would go through it, and then the door would kind of like fold back in itself. And that was how I went through the door. But obviously there's two doors in my house, one for the living room and one for the actual outside. There's more than two doors, but I'm just saying these are the two doors I went through. So I had to do the same to get outside. Push through the door, and it would bubble around me, like to the pressure of me, as if I was air again for a glass blower. And I would push through this door and go through it. And I did some things, nothing to note, but just had a little wander outside in the dream. Haven't been lucid for a long time. Like, not like that anyway. And yeah, and then I woke up to the sound of my alarm because my nap had finished. And that was my dream. Very odd. I've never had the experience of such a successful cowled like that. I've had similar experiences, but nothing to the experience of a dream character trying to push. And that's the thing I like about it. It wasn't like the dream character's like, "You're dreaming, by the way." It was like, come on. It was like a teacher. Like, come on, you know the answer to this. And he was trying to etch me on to the actual answer that I was dreaming. And I like that. It was odd. And that's pretty much it for today. Don't forget to subscribe to the second channel, link in the description box below. New videos will be coming out on that. I say new videos. The first video will be coming out on the 1st of January. So be part of it, because things are going to get mental new year. And I want to say a big thank you to the Patreon supporters and to the YouTube memberships. Thank you very much, all of you. And until next time I make a video, which could be from now until the end of time, bye!